What's up guys, this is Max Square, and in this video, I'm gonna be showing you my number one tool for cleaning up hard drive space on your Mac. I've been using this app for at least a couple years now, and I have not been able to find a better alternative since. So we're gonna jump right into that, but if you are new here, I make videos all about how to increase your productivity on your Mac, iPad, and iPhone. So if that is something you're into, consider subscribing down below. But without further ado, let's jump into the review. So this app is called DaisyDisk, and I believe it's about 10 bucks. And as soon as you open it up, it'll just show you a list of all of your connected hard drives. So obviously I have my internal hard drive that's just built into my Mac. I've also got my team drive there if I needed to scan that. And I've got an external hard drive. But you can also scan a folder, so if you just wanna break it down to a specific folder on any one of your drives, or maybe you plug in an external drive, you don't wanna scan the whole thing, you could do that there. I'm gonna go ahead and scan my main hard drive. So this is a terabyte drive, so it may take a minute or two. Obviously, the bigger it is, the longer it takes to scan, but honestly, you can see it does a pretty quick job at getting all the information. And what's really cool is you get to see visually what's taking up a lot of space, and it is color-coded as well. So you can see users is obviously gonna be the biggest, and that's in green. And you can kind of click into things to see what's taking up space inside of that. So if you have cache or whatever this is, you can kind of click into those certain files and keep going from there. So obviously I like to start with the biggest stuff. So just go into users. Obviously my main user is gonna be the biggest thing. And we can go into pictures. And now I can see that my photos library is taking up over 130 gigs. So I wouldn't wanna delete that, but maybe I could go into my photo library and, you know, delete some duplicates or whatever like that just to free up some space. So I can already see that that's taking up a lot of space, but I could go back and maybe jump into my library and I can see that I have 50 gigs of cache. So a lot of that's coming from Adobe, and the majority of that is in After Effects. So I could actually just take this whole folder and drag it and drop it and then just hit delete. Now you do get a couple of seconds just to cancel if you, you know, accidentally make a mistake or you're about to delete something really important. But right then and there, I've just cleaned up 52 gigs of hard drive space. Now obviously make sure you know what you're doing when you're deleting these files. I accidentally made the mistake of deleting an entire cache folder which had a plugin that I needed, and it took me like an entire weekend to get it back and installed. So obviously just make sure. But other than that, it's really easy to go in and free up space. One example is that I always download tons of video files and just generally big files. And obviously that goes to my downloads folder. And then sometimes I'll copy it, or somehow there's duplicates, or I've already used the file, I don't need it anymore. And those just get left in my downloads. So every couple of weeks, I'll just go in there and check. And usually there's near 100 gigs of space just being taken up in my downloads. And you can just go into the downloads folder and select whatever it is you need. Or if you know you don't need anything in downloads, just go to Finder, you know, go to download, select everything, and hit delete like that. Now one kind of annoying thing with DaisyDisk is you can only have one window open at a time. So if you did need to scan another hard drive, you just have to jump back to the main menu and then click into the drive that you need. Now in this case, I'm scanning a 12 terabyte RAID drive, and even then it did a pretty quick job. So again, we can go in and see that that yellow, which is around here, is business. That's taking up a lot of space, specifically the content folder. And you'll notice that as I hover over these sections, it does change in the sidebar. So when I go to the orange, content and the main folder is there, but when I go to green, that's for my vlog and other stuff there. So obviously having a lot of video files is gonna take up a lot of space, but sometimes you can jump into a folder or, you know, your applications or whatever and see that there's a huge file that you don't even use anymore. And sometimes that's enough to free up enough space for whatever it is you need. Now, one thing probably every Mac user has struggled with is seeing that other is taking up a lot of space on their hard drive and then not really being able to do anything about it. It may be labeled as system now and later versions or whatever, but everyone has encountered this. And so what's nice about DaisyDisk is they will label that as hidden space, and you can go in there and see what is taking up space. Now, if you do want to delete that or access those files any bit more, you will actually have to download another version of the app. It is free and they'll show you how to do it. You just click that button, takes you to their website and you install it. But once you get it, you basically just rescan it as the administrator. And I think ultimately having the other app is just because Mac doesn't allow, due to permissions, access to those hidden files or whatever the case may be. The point is, then you can go into those files and actually be able to delete that in this version of the app. So it's kind of annoying to have to go through that process, but you only have to do it once and it is free. They're not charging you anything else. And again, I'm just throwing this in there, but you do wanna make sure you know what you're deleting. This, for example, this purgeable space has something to do with my time machine. So I'm a little hesitant to just go ahead and delete it. But sometimes there's stuff in there like other cache, maybe you have old text or whatever. So you know that you know you can just delete it. So maybe you will go in here and use that for that function. But this is just a nice way to see exactly what other is rather than just seeing a gray or like a yellow bar taking up a ton of space on your computer. So that's really it for this app. Like I said, I've been using it for a couple of years now and I've really been enjoying it. Another thing is that none of this was being paid. This video is not sponsored. I am just making this review because I think people would enjoy and benefit from using this app in their workflow to free up space. So if you did enjoy it, be sure to like this video and subscribe for more. Thank you so much for watching and I will see you in the next one.